Expected was a slow build-up and dominance by Tunisia, a couple more goals and going maybe 2-0 up at half-time.
Well, certainly when he picks the ball up and Sakmi, he does really well because the fullback Jamal goes on an overlap and it just takes the centre-half Jimmy away. So he gets turned and he starts running at the heart of the defence. And watch out for the number 13, Chikota. He gets out the way just as he's running through and that makes it easy for him just to side-foot it, pass it into the corner of the net. That wasn't a great tackle from Haruna. Then the number 13 has disappeared out the pitcher. He should have been making the challenge. But this all changed it, didn't it?
Now, what about this? The goalkeeper thinks he was fouled. There's a hint that maybe Mazu touched it with his hand. He certainly went to try and smack it in with his hand.
Well, I've been watching a lot of the replays. From this angle, you can't tell. But there is one angle. He actually does touch the ball with his hand, Mazu. Is it this one?
No.
No, you don't see it on that one. There's another one from behind the goal where he touches the ball with his hand. It just takes it away from the goalkeeper. If the goalkeeper had caught it for the first time, it wouldn't have been a problem. But this man has been a threat throughout the first half, Mazu. He should score here, but it's his pace. He runs away from what seems to be a sluggish centre-half in Hagui. Driving with pace and power. There's the first touch. Now he should finish. Instead, he just gets underneath it. And this is even better. Goes between the two defenders, he shows great power and pace, but then at the end of it, just can't get the finish. But he's been the biggest threat to Tunisia. Niger's centre-forward, who's been out on the left-hand side at times, Mazu.
OK, then teams will be out for the second half. We'll take a break, we'll be back in a couple of minutes.